I wasn't as big and as strong and as fast as Tap. I'll never be that. And I played at a small school, Shadron, Nebraska, Division II. We were really good, but I had more sacks than he did. And it's not in here, it's in here. That's what I tell Tap that all the time.
Sounds like you've got your family finally relocated to Blacksburg, Coach. How does that feel to finally get settled in here?
We're settled in. We probably have 95% of our boxes done and unpacked. And I just turned 42. This was my 18th move. So this is normal. It's everyday life. That's what we do. Let's go coach football.
You obviously grew up in a football household. Your father, John, who you lost earlier this year, is a household name where I'm from, in Minneapolis, of course, and throughout football circles. A lot of people know his football philosophy, and I'm certain you've soaked up a tremendous amount of that. But what was John Teerlink, the man, like?
All the Super Bowls he's won, all the Hall of Famers he's coached, all the All-Pros he's coached, all the Pro Bowlers, was awesome. Like, that's why I coached, is because of what he did. But he was a dad first, a friend second, and a coach third. And in a weird way, when he passed away, I realized how far my dad's a giant man. When we go out to practice tomorrow, you're going to look at me and I'm not going to be a big dude. My dad was a behemoth. He was 6'6". He's a 300 pounder. And I used to joke with my dad how he hated people, but he was a big man with a long reach. And he touched everybody from every different aspect of the facility. And he was loved by many. And I had no idea how many people it affected when he passed. And it was very powerful. And that just, me coming back to college football and can help, you know, benefit people, that was part of the draw.
How much of who he was as a man and a father, Bill, has passed on to you? It sounds like all of that. And same question as it pertains to your football philosophy and what you're trying to impart on your D lineman here in Blacksburg.
Oh yeah. And if you know my old man, it's, we're going to get off the ball, we're going to run wild, and we're going to go attack, and we're going to go get people. And that was his life, and that's who he was, and that's what we do, and that's what we teach. Everything you do in life is important. Not just, if I got to go mow the grass today, I'm going to do it 100 miles an hour. If I got to take a nap today, I'm going to do it 100 miles an hour, but I'm going to take a sleep. If I got to go get the mail, if I got to go get groceries, everything we do is full speed ahead, but you got to understand where the meter is and what's important and how fast you go and how slow you go.
So I grew up a Vikings fan. My favorite player was John Randall. I know he was a guy that you were around. You've been around and now coached a tremendous amount of elite pass rushers, Dwight Freeney, Robert Mathis, those types of guys. What are the key things outside of the physical gifts that make those type of players?
John Randall was different. My old man coached in 4 Super Bowls, won 3, but inducted John Randall to the Hall of Fame. One of maybe 3 or 4 assistant coaches to ever induct somebody. And he said every game, every day he's coached, every Super Bowl he's won, inducting Randall was the best, the highlight of his career. And John Randall was a 12th rounder, Texas A&I Kingsville, slept on a dirt floor. And my dad said, if you want to be great, listen to me, we'll go to work. Now, John Randall was a wild man. And I tell the story to our guys every day. Anytime you see a pole on the street, no matter what you do, you should work a move. Every time you open a meeting room door, you should work a move. Do something. John Randall did that in the Walmart at 2 a.m, and they called the police on him. And they said, well, what happened? Is he bad? He's like, I just worked a spin move. She was in the aisle. I wanted frozen pizza. She was getting frozen potatoes, and I worked a spin. Am I wrong? No, you're not wrong. But the perception is, but that's why John Randall was great, because he did everything the way it should be. And you're either in or you're out. And John Randall was all the way in, and there's 100 million people that have more talent than that guy. But John Randall's will and willing to be coached and his attitude made him great. And that's what I took from Randall and some of those elite level players, is even when it's the off season and I'm in Walmart at 1 a.m. looking for deodorant, I'm working a move.
Let's go back out of the field, Bill. You didn't coach him personally, but Tremaine Edmonds, of course, blossomed here at Virginia Tech. He's a physical freak. But outside of that, what has allowed him, in your opinion, to become a Pro Bowl player so quickly?
Nobody knows this, but in the last 2 or 3 years, who's had a better defense than the Bills? The answer is nobody. Like, we finished second by 20 yards and third by like 100 yards. So, like, the defense, the system works, and Tremaine has to come in and be the quarterback. And all he did was take control of everything. I saw the biggest, strongest, fastest man I've ever seen. And he might have been 14 when he came to us. That's how young he was. And I know that's joking, but he was the youngest player in the NFL. And he came in and was an adult since day one. And why did he do that? Because the structure of Coach Fu, Coach Hilgart, and Coach Cornelison, and everybody, Coach Hamilton, everybody, like, he came in prepped, ready for this. I've never met a more mature, immature person in my life. And it was lights out. It was lights out. He's an unbelievable person. You can't find a flaw about him, except he needs to get off his wallet.
Yeah, it's funny because his brother...
He had rookie dinner, and he split it three ways with 2 free agents. You're a first-round pick. You got to buy the rookie dinner.
Mama Edmonds is not going to be happy to hear that, because...
Oh, no. No, and I met them, and that's why they're so good. The Edmonds family is so epic and so prepared and so awesome. That's great. That's why he split it. You make more money than anybody on the team, and you make this guy split it with you. No, you got to go. But that's why he's so good.
Well, Bill, we got a couple minutes left. Let's go rapid fire here on this dunk and take it to the house real quick. I know you got to get back out on the field. Favorite memory coaching together with your pop in Indianapolis?
When we had a day off and I worked across the hall from him every day for 5 years, and on my day off, I went home and we barbecued. Like, even though we weren't working, what am I going to do on my day off? I'm going to go hang out with Dad, fire up the smoker. And if you go past medium, you're wrong.
Well, that is a fact. I mean, that's an indisputable.
You go
fact.
Past medium, you're wrong.
We'll get you out of here on this one, Bill. How excited are you about this group that you've taken over here in Blacksburg?
Oh, I couldn't be more excited. We got old, we got young, we got big, we got small, we got strong, we got fast. We got the perfect blend, and it's up to us as coaches is to mix the potion together and figure out what shakes out. But, like, we're going to be okay. And we're going to practice every day like we're going to get ready for a game, and we'll see what happens. And I'm going to be up early tomorrow. If anybody's got any more questions, I'll be up at 6 with Pete. Let's go.
I'll be over in the weight room. I don't know how I got conned into it, but I...
Oh, yeah. I ain't going to be in the weight room, but I'll be up here at 6 if anybody wants to hang out.
Awesome to hang it out with you. Can't wait to do it again. Can't wait to do it in person.
All right, John, appreciate
Thanks,
it.
Man. Awesome stuff.
All right, buddy. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?